In this video, I show you how to create jump cuts in Shotcut. Hi everyone, my name is Joe and welcome to Ubitronics. On this channel, I show you how to use open source software. Today, we're looking at the jump cut in Shotcut. So the first thing I've done is created my own small video here and then dragged that into the playlist. And then I've got a stock image as well, a stock video that I've also dragged into the playlist for later. Now, the first thing I'm going to do is drag my video into the timeline. And this video needs to be cut. As you can see, the bits where I speak are here. Here's the audio wave. And I've got lots of white space here, lots of white space here, and as we go through, I'm going to play through the whole video in a few minutes and you'll see how we can jump cut all of this video up to a much smaller, more precise and accurate video that actually is quite interesting and performs much better than if you were going to leave all of this this space and time into the video. So hopefully that makes sense. Let's jump straight into it and I'm going to start by playing the first part of this video. Hi everyone, my name is Joe and welcome to Ubitronics. On this channel I show you how to use open source software. Today we're looking at jump cuts in Shotcut. So the very first part there, you've already heard once. I've repeated it again for the sake of this video, but that's a good start. It's a good introduction and I want to keep that piece of audio, but actually I've got quite a bit of space either side. And if you noticed right at the beginning here, I've actually got my head kind of down in my notes. So I'm looking at my notes there and I'm just about to start speaking. But actually what we want to do is take the playhead, this bit here, and take it to where you want the video to start. For me, that looks about right. And then you click split just here. This will split the video. And then you can delete this bit because this is all the bit that we don't need. And right click remove to just snap the video right to the beginning of the timeline. So now instead of having all of that white space at the start, I've now got a nice starting position. I'm smiling on the screen and it jumps straight into the video.
Hi everyone, my name is Joe and welcome to Ubitronics. On this channel, I show you how to use open source software. Today, we're looking at jump cuts in Shotcut.
Okay, so I've stopped talking here and I'm the next part of the video, if I keep playing it, I look back down into the notes and get my notes, get everything said in my head, and then I start speaking again. So what I want to do is cut it about there and also cut out this bit here, and I'll right click remove, and now when I play it again,
cuts in Shotcut. So first of all, what are jump cuts? Well, jump cuts are the act of cutting up your video in the video editing software so that when you come to view your video and you create the final production, you've missed out all of the mistakes and you've cut out all of the bits of video that you no longer want.
So fantastic. That's a nice little bit of information for you whilst we're creating this video. I've just stopped speaking there, so I'm going to cut it once more. If I drag it through, you're going to see that I am going back into my notes looking for another sentence. And I'm going to cut it again there and I'm going to remove. Now I've just taken out the white space. I'm going to play
video that you no longer want. The main reasons for using a jump cut is to keep the viewer's attention and to cut out the mistakes that may have been created during the video. It can also add excitement and tension into a video if you're filming more of a production, like a proper film. In terms of when you're creating a YouTube video or something similar to my style of video here, then it's mainly used to keep the viewer's attention.
Fab. And we can see by the end of the video, that's just white space. So I'm just going to chop that off again, remove it, so we don't have loads of empty space either side of the video. Now that's how to perform the most basic and simple jump cut. It will put all of your video clips together and also your audio, but you can also do more with a jump cut. So let's imagine that I want to emphasize this bit here, this section here that I'm just about to cut here in here. I've got no idea what I'm actually saying at this point, but I'm just going to imagine that this section here, I want to emphasize. How can I do that visually? Well, in the audio, you can't really do much about that, but in the video, you can come up to filters, plus, size, position, rotate, and then you can zoom in slightly here. And what that will do is when you play it.
Everyone, my name is Joe and welcome to Ubitronics. On this channel, I show you how to use open source software.
As you can see, it zooms in and then back out. And that's quite a common tactic, especially in YouTube videos. Something that you might want to be doing in conjunction with your jump cut to make your video more enticing and appealing to your viewers. Now, for those of you that are interested, then the jump cut is actually called a jump cut because it just completely cuts. There's no transition, there's no fade, there's no special effects or anything. It just cuts from one video to another. Now, that doesn't have to be the same video like I've just done here. It could be B-roll or it could be a completely different scene of a video. Entirely up to you. Just to demonstrate that, if I was to detach the audio here, and I'll remove this piece of video here, and I'll come up to my playlist and add in the second clip that I prepared. Whoops, I don't want to overwrite it. I'm going to click the ripple and then add it in after that. And what that'll do is move all of the timeline over instead of overwriting. Then I can just tidy up the ends by cutting the video down, turning off ripple, and then remove the white space. So now effectively what happens is I've got a jump cut and it will jump to a different video, but my audio will carry on playing in the background.
On this channel, I show you how to use open source software. Today, we're looking at jump cuts in Shotcut. So first of all, what are jump cuts?
So not a particularly fantastic example there, but it does get the idea across to you. You can use your B-roll whilst keeping your audio and doing your jump cuts. You can also zoom in, or you can just do basic jump cuts to take out mistakes or white space within your videos and make it much cleaner and more precise. I hope that's helped. Please consider liking and subscribing, and I'll see you in the next video.